All right, so the top of the turn of 538 BC, we do have the army coming down to Tadmor. I think what I'm going to do, while I march Cambogia up there, looks like they're rallying all their forces now. This is the last push into their territory, so they're going to defend it tooth and nail. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to meet them on the field. I do have a bit of an advantage. I only have a little bit of money left. I might hire a mercenary or two just to even things out. But perhaps what will happen is that I'll hire mercenaries after the battle, depending on how bad my losses are, just so we can kind of keep the momentum going. In Fra, they have besieged, and they actually haven't built, wow, are those things called? Battering rams. They haven't built any battering rams yet, because there's too small a force, so I'm going to try to defend that as much as possible, actually. Man, I have a big force here, but I'm terrified of that stack of the Bactrians. As I mentioned before, let's bring... Oh, man, that's not even guarded either. No. Yeah. So we're going to go ahead and push through here and go towards Opania. And here, we're going to go ahead, take this bridge, and take Batella as well. So I'll get back to you on updates with that. Other than that, everything else is going pretty well. As you can see, I've completely shifted gears to my normal conservative defensive slow progress mode into an all-out blitz. So hopefully this will be exciting for those of you who tell me my progress is going too slow, because now we're gonna hit these Babylonians and later the Medians as hard as we possibly can. All right, without further ado, let's go ahead and attack Captain Hyan. I will have an advantage of having my leader there. It is giving us a 5-3 advantage. They have full units, but I have more of them. And hopefully my tactics will win the day. We'll see. I will see you on the battle map. Alright, exact same formation as before. It worked last time. Hopefully it will work this time. Now, they didn't set up by this hill. I thought they were going to, but they didn't. So, I'm going to go ahead and charge ahead and try to take at least some sort of hill advantage, while I sweep my missile cavalry. Whoops. Wrong thing here. There we go, something like that. There we go. Sweep these guys around to this side. Alright, let's see how well we do. I think they're gonna turn to face me, but hopefully... Oh yeah, here they come. Alright. Hopefully we can knock out. Alright. Go ahead and stop. Alright, we'll have everyone stop now. We're as close as we're gonna get. Alright. We gotta hammer their light cavalry first. Then, with that out of the way, we'll have some mobility and missile superiority. Typically means they're gonna charge us. Oh, you guys are totally... What? Oh, because you turned yourselves around. Alright, they're pretty weak on that side. Getting there on the opposite side. Oh, yeah. Alright. Time to, bring my infantry. Well, let's bring them up. Let's hit them hard on this side here. These guys aren't doing anything. Okay, looks like they're reforming, as per usual, as the AI is wont to do. Alright, I see a bunch of dead horses, and I also see missile units exposed, so let's go ahead and charge into them. Completely sweep them up. You guys are gonna have to go here. King, you know what? I see an opening here, so we're gonna go here. We'll have the companions guard them as well. Missile units need new targets. Like that giant, fat center there. That is a juicy target. You guys reform back here, though. Alright, took care of them pretty easy. Now they're in trouble. Got them all blocked up here. That's not good. Not good for them, at least. Alright. Let's take care of these missile units real quick. And then go for a rear charge in this center mass. Okay, you stop charging for a moment. You go after them. You go after them. You hit them in the back. Alright, come on. Take care of them. You know what? Attack them right in the back. Took care of them. They're broken. Let's bring up our own cav. Alright. We're open now for a charge into their missile units. Alright. Expect a mass rout soon. Yeah, they broke on the left flank. Okay, stop for a moment. Bodyguard, charge in. There goes the enemy general. Now they're wavering. Arrows are flying everywhere. Alright, it's a total rout. I will see you at the results screen. Alright, so that was a clear victory with 1,984 kills and around 400 losses. Here's the detailed screen here for you, for those of you who are interested. Alright, I'll see you back at the campaign map. Alright, that was a total rout. Completely annihilated them. Now we're going to bring our forces back here down to Tidmore. We're going to go ahead and merge these two units. And you know what? I think this is strong enough. I think I'm going to hold off on the mercenaries until I really, really need it, and maybe when I have a little bit more money. Instead, I do have some reinforcements coming. They can replenish this force. In the meantime, Kambujia, the Conqueror, he can move on to the next target, because I'm pretty sure Tadmor, with the reinforcements, can handle, you know, whatever they're going to throw at us here. And Kambujia? I don't know. Anyways, he's going to head over to Damascus, and take it. Alright, so it looks like at the top of the summer of 538 BC that the Babylonians are content at defending Nisibis here, or at least they're consolidating their power, which is probably wise. We're going to actually... Mighty General, Sire. First, let's try something real quick. Yeah, just because I can do it in one turn, wow, how impatient can I possibly be, eh? I'm going to go ahead and take Cyrus the Cunning here, and he's going to attack this army here, and then lead on to Damascus, while Kambujia kind of holds down the fort here, attacking all. Maybe he'll send out... Orders? We can probably send out a small force, and we'll probably take care of Akia here as well. So that's what we'll do. Let's see, what else are we doing? Reinforcements are being funneled over to the war in the west. Still haven't taken this. Let's see if they have any... Okay, so I'm going to actually try to defend. I probably won't show because it's like three units versus two units. But I might actually be able to hold off the town, and if I can, well, that'll just be hilarious. Go ahead here on the east, we're going to go ahead and take this town that we've besieged. Once again, they have minuscule units. When I scattered it out, I think they have a total of like 5 elephants, not very many. So that'll be easy to deal with. Oh, this seems nice and open, so after we take care of this small army, we're going to make our way over to Opina. So hopefully the Indians will give us a break, and they'll focus on trying to reclaim their territories rather than go after my own. Keep an aggressive boundary, man. Alright, that's the plan for this summer. I'll get back to you at a major battle or a new happening. Alright, so one last little bit here. Once again, that small army retreated to right beside Damascus, and once again I can take it. I'm not going to show this battle this time because it's going to be so minor. Unless this guy's our new factionaire. I don't think he is. I'm just going to auto-resolve this, so I'll get back to you. Actually, I've decided against auto-resolving. Auto-resolving, I need as many men as possible, and I lose less when I fight the battle myself, so I'm going to just fight it and not show you the results. Alright. Well, that was frustrating. I lost about 200 men with that, and sorry I didn't show you the results, but I was so disgusted because a lot of their units managed to run away. So now I am besieging this town, so I'm here a turn longer than I wanted, but that doesn't mean I still can't handle it, so I should be okay. Yeah. Here we are! Alright, so this we have actually taken Paktia. We're going to just occupy the settlement. We're going to bring down the taxes. We have to repair a few buildings that were set on fire. And it doesn't look like we can hold it. So instead, we're going to take our army. And we're going to head back towards the border here. And have them retake it. Let's actually have our fellow talk with them and say if they want a bloody ceasefire. Nope. Fine, be that way. Be all lame. Alright, while they're distracted down there, we're gonna go ahead and... Oh, now here's the question. Will they go ahead and attack this? Now we might as well take care of them. Alright, top of the turn! 538 BC winter. So I'm gonna go ahead and take Damascus. Hopefully that'll go on without much of a hitch. I'll just auto-resolve that battle. So unless they have some heroic units, I don't think we'll have a problem. We're going to keep defending here in Tadmir, and then between these two cities, we'll determine where to strike out next. Of course, we do have some Babylonian diplomats hanging around us. Maybe they'll want peace, but we're not going to accept it. We're going to just go for their complete and total destruction. Might as well. Over here in the north, we did manage to actually keep Fra. I actually didn't care at the end of it and just auto-resolved it, and I ended up winning, so yay! But this larger force has come up here, but we're going to take pretty much everybody, except for, we'll say, these guys, and a unit of these guys. There we go. And we're going to go ahead and meet them in the field. And I'll probably show that battle, because that's a relatively big one. Just don't want you to think I'm auto-resolving everything either. That would be most unfortunate. We're going to head up towards... Well, this seems like the fastest route. Yeah, alright, let's just go up this way. Oh, yeah, there... I see. Alright, we'll head up there. We can go ahead and just defend... here at this Persian fort. If we see a big army come on by, we'll probably get the hell out of there. But in the meantime, let's just take our spy, make sure we have no one... No, that's pretty much the resistance up there. We can crush that, take that, and head back towards the safety of Persia. They did reclaim Patala, which is good, because if I remember correctly, what actually sabotaged my Spartan campaign was when settlements rebel... the game crashes, and you can never fix it. So, that's that. So that's the plan for this turn. Alright, so we're just gonna... I went ahead and auto-resolved the battle for Damascus. We actually only had 73 losses, which makes up for the losses I took on the field. Of course, the second I say, oh, I'm better than the auto-resolve, the game has to prove me wrong. Alright, so there we go. Now we have ourselves Damascus. All ours now. Thank you very much. We'll build that. Oh, man. I'm just floating by on money. So we're going to tax these guys as much as possible, at least until next turn. We'll repair the walls, too. You never know when you're going to need that. And go ahead and merge up what we have here by pressing the M button. And then I think what we'll do is that Cambodia here, he'll defend. And we'll wait for these reinforcements to... Actually, you know what? I don't want to wait for reinforcements. So what I'm going to do is do a little swap. I'm going to take my depleted units here. Yeah, even them. And them. They... Because... Yeah, they can go down here. Okay, so what I'm going to do... Depleted unit. Depleted. 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 Anything else? Nope. You're going to go up north here. You could take, let's see here, what could we use? Oh, depleted. Let's see here, 1, 2, 3, 4. We could use, we'll say 3 more spear, no, 2, yeah, 3 more spear units. A few more missiles, and there, 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 and there. And why not? Slightly better. Actually, we can merge up these Stracatians. No, we can't merge up the Stracatians. Damn. Oh, we'll take this appeal. Palathu. This. There. Now we'll be all set, and we'll strike out for probably Jerusalem. Ooh, Jerusalem. That'll be next turn.